What's up everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video we are going to check the difference between traveling with load and without load. So why it might be interesting? Because normally we are traveling to work and back and we know how much car consume energy, we know our range, but if we are traveling on vacation to, let's say, to the mountains, to the cabin, other places, to visit family, then we take, let's say, two people on board, or I don't know, the adult, child and luggage, or just the other stuff or other things to the car, then we will understand what is the difference and possibly how much the range is reduced. And we already know the stats for Tesla and BMW i3s, and now we are going to find out what's the stats for Mini Cooper S Electric. So I hope you will find it useful. Consider subscribing this channel because you don't want to miss another video. And I try to post video every week so you can have entertainment or you can just find out more about the cars. And I'm also testing electric vehicles. So that's something what I do as a hobby and you might too watch it as a fun. So enjoy and let's get started. So we are going to charge the battery up to 75% this time. Then we need to check the weather for today. So it's evening, it's 17 degrees of Celsius. It's a bit cloudy outside and the side wind is 14 kilometers per hour. As you can see, there are water bottles and some boxes to increase the weight of the car. In addition, I'm taking my wife and child for a 100 kilometers trip. I'm driving always the same road. Thanks to that, I can compare the result with other cars. So why is that important? Mini Cooper S Electric has quite small battery, which means every loss in range might be significant. So now you see the picture with a test made before and the other picture made after adding a load. As you can see on the graph, Mini Cooper Electric driving with load is consuming only 6% of energy more, which is a little bit less than BMW i3, way less than Tesla Model S 75D. That means in the real world scenario, range of Mini Cooper will be shortened by only 12 kilometers, where range of Tesla will be reduced by 30 kilometers. Why is that important? Tesla has a large battery capacity and losing around 7% of range doesn't make a difference. You will still have 390 kilometers of range. However, the situation is different for Mini. Losing only 6% of energy, range will be reduced down to 190 kilometers. Is that relevant? You tell me in the comments down below. I have a bonus for you. After charging Mini for about half an hour, the time has come for another test. I wanted to show you result from noise test. Unfortunately, noise meter didn't work properly. So I've used my phone with extra app to record the noise at different speeds. Take a look if that has a sense. So what is influencing the noise level? That's for sure the tires, the wind speed, the speed of the car and other things. So we are here with Hankook Ventus S1 Evo 3 tires, 205-45R17. So it's 90. I'm not sure if these measurements are correct because the noise meter is showing something different and app is showing something else. So if you can recommend me some decent tool in the comment down below, I would be thankful. Anyways, that's, I think it's interesting to see, maybe for fun. And I want to thank you for watching this video and I see you in the next one. Cheers!